right, here we go.
It's very possible.
What's going on? Imhip is playing
Inkling?
I thought he got this far going Olimar.
He did get this far going Olimar. I don't know how his loser's bracket one runs, but he usually goes Olimar. But you know, I got the SoCal local info, and Larry kind of sauces his own.
Really? Okay, so I can see why he went Inkling. Actually, however, I can't see why he went Inkling. Oh, wait, wait. Because I don't know what's going on right here. However, if you can edgeguard Fox really well, then you'll have a fantastic day. However, he's at this percent where he can get neutral air into up smash.
It's just so tough because Imhip is definitely like a projectile character specialist. I'm not saying he can't play Inkling, but he's really, really good at playing projectile characters. So Inkling definitely not that category in my opinion. Definitely a character that kind of like that combo, quick orientated character, very movement based.
I actually think Inkling's one of the hardest top tier characters to play. People think Inkling's easy, just get the roller, but once you can't get the roller anymore, that's where you begin to have a lot of trouble and you can't do anything.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's when it becomes very troublesome to kill. All right, we good. Yeah, like you said, once if you can't get roller, it gets really troublesome to kill. The back throw does kill, but if you just like stay in the middle of the stage, then you're good.
Oh my gosh! I feel like we all saw that coming. There's this thing where foxes, like, they get one up here and they're like, ew. Then they get the second and they're like, ew. Like, they're gonna go for the third up here off the platform. You have to air dodge no matter what. All right, unless you're fighting Light, because he always waits for the air dodge. Like, after he does a lot of damage. But
that's, like, the one guy.
Yeah, that's the one guy.
That's the one. All right, but everyone else, you gotta air dodge.
You got it.
You know they want it. You know they want the cliff. Like, they just want to keep up airing you.
They want to pretend like it's melee. They're like, wait, ultimate's faster? You can kind of wave dash? Let's be melee. Oh, let's be melee.
Hey, oh, melee?
Oh my.
Woo, that was a crispy, clean edge guard, and Imhip knows it. We saw him reeling back in his chair. Slight eye roll, but a respectful eye roll.
Oh, man. I actually feel bad for Imhip right now. Like you said, he has trouble going Olimar versus Larry. Larry kind of.
Oh, man.
He goes in on Olimar.
We're
going to
see the Olimar. Come on. Imhip, please.
I don't know. I just feel like it's not the answer. It's Larry. Larry used to destroy Rich Brown back in the ball days. There was one time he lost to the Buzz.
It's just a comfort pick at this point. I just feel like he's not. And not to diss Imhip or anything, but I just don't feel like his Inkling is quite ready for a player on Larry's caliber.
It's really hard to play Inkling. We already saw that. There's only been one top 8 at a national Inkling. That was Cosmos.
And that's
able
a
to
solo
do it.
Inkling main. Yeah, the solo. Best Inkling.
Yeah, exactly.
Solo.
He put his whole heart into Inkling. And he got 7th. Come on. he's trying to. But I think I can place higher than 7th. No.
All right, so let's talk about Olimar. Because I love talking about how crazy good this character is. Just in case Nintendo's watching. So anyway, very insane character.
They're watching.
Up smash.
But yeah, insane character with the up smash.
Yeah, I mean, it's just he's a projectile character, but since they changed his properties on his aerials to be like regular aerials, he's actually a sword character with projectiles.
Oh, wow. That's really – okay, so basically better than the last game for certain.
Oh, for certain. And that up smash on block is safe.
Wow.
You can up smash into up smash as a block string. It is so darn good. And it's a combo starter into the up air string. This character just has very, very good overall just everything. I mean, the weakest point is probably his recovery.
Yeah, his recovery could be a little questionable because it's very slow. However, it doesn't matter too much. One thing about Olimar, though, I feel Olimar Loki is really slow whenever you get in front of his face and you start attacking. Olimar can't.
You can definitely smother him. I do think Fox wins this matchup.
Yeah.
Fox is a character with a shine. Has very fast movement speed. Like you said, Olimar being very slow. He can get up in Olimar's space and always be in that boxing range. And Olimar doesn't want to be there. He wants to be at that mid-range spacing out.
Exactly. However, Olimar doing fantastic right now. One F smash, another F smash,
man.
Another one. Oh, double spot dodge.
That looked like Keitaro off.
Yeah, that did. That's why I respect it, but it didn't work, so I feel sad. But we do have Fox at 139%, 141. And keep in mind, Fox is one of the lightest characters in the game.
Oh, yeah.
Fifth lightest or something?
He's
I don't know.
Tied with Mewtwo. He's the same weight as Mewtwo.
What is going on? I know Mewtwo's made of balloons, but Fox doesn't look like it.
He has metal feet, man. Where'd the weight go?
Exactly.
Did it turn into aluminum?
Ooh, that's going to be a strong punish coming out from Imhip, but only a charge F smash. Let's see.
Ooh, yep. There's the damage coming out from Larry. Like you said, you know, Fox has the tools to get in. The dash attack is so, so good. Has all these very quick tilts when you're up close to him. Can just be a monster of just brain data you have to fight.
Wow, I feel like Imhip can't play the game. Imhip is just sitting there on the ledge or running away. Look at this. It's been like 30 seconds of Imhip on the ledge. He finally gets off and he's dead. It's like, come on. He can't play the game.
Yeah.
Larry, too much pressure right now on Imhip.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, Larry just being one of the best ledge trappers from Smash 4, you know, up there with Tweak and Zero. Like, when he puts a character on a ledge, he just can be so proficient at not letting you play the game, pretty much.
All right, I'm down for that. And Larry's still, again, doing a fantastic job. I feel like he's not getting hit by the sudden trap from Imhip. Imhip, okay, that's finally one he got hit by, but no KO. But Imhip sometimes will run back and just F smash and be like, all right, I got you. But no, Larry always blocks it. Like, look, example right there.
Wow, and the trade with the forwarder. I think Imhip was able to squeeze out a down smash.
Yep. Good stuff by Imhip, however, 56%. That's not a big deal for Olimar, especially if he has the white Pikmin that he can throw it on Fox. But again, Fox is Reflector, infinite pressure, 93%, he's ready to die.
Yeah, and Olimar, very, very light character, gets the roll on the stage. Larry with no reaction. Is he going to go for the up smash? Oh, we have him off stage, though. This is no jump on Larry.
Uh-oh, this is Fox again. However, he did not see that read of the side B up high. Ooh.
Larry, wait a minute.
Olimar strong. Oh, that's that F smash.
He's
no, what was
the
that?
Larry bet it all on the up smash, and Imhip with the head nod with a very brilliant shield there. He did not crack under the pressure. He knew, hey, if I get grabbed in this situation, I'm not going to die. I can. If he goes for anything over extension, my next lineup is purple.
That's so, the scary thing about Fox. I believe it was Void who said Fox has to extend or reach out more than Wolf has to. So Fox has to for, like, he has to try to, like, risk himself a little bit more or go for something where it's like, hey, you might be able to punish me. So he tried to go for it. He went for that up smash. That was a position where Larry had it all in his control.
Yes.
He could have ran up and grabbed. However, he said, you know what? Nah, he's going to drop a shield. And he didn't drop a shield. Dead.
Yep. Maybe he was trying to go for a drum freeze, but nonetheless, like you said, Fox being that committal rush down spacey and Wolf being the non-committal one. You know, he's got the claws, he's got the blaster. He's good to go.
He's good to go, man. And again, Imhip, he went Olimar, he was able to take a game. This might be it. This might be the one time he's able to take out Larry.
Yeah. I mean, so far, Imhip has not taken a set off of Larry Lurr, but maybe the heart of battle will be the tournament he doesn't.
All right, maybe he has the heart of battle. What does that even mean? Like,
the answer always lies in the heart of battle.
What? All right, I just thought it was a Yu-Gi-Oh! reference, Kaiba.
Kingdom Hearts just came out.
Kingdom Hearts? Wait, that's Kingdom Hearts?
Huh?
That's a Kingdom Hearts reference?
The heart of battle?
Yeah.
I mean, if you want it to be.
Oh my goodness. But the heart of battle is here, top eight. And already a stock being taken from Imhip. This looks like this might be a lot better stage choice. I remember back in a Smash 4 days, and even Brawl, this was a really good stage for Fox.
Why is that, Kitaro?
I actually don't know. But she just does good here.
You know. Actually know. You're trolling
okay,
me.
Okay, okay. Actually, you're right. He's really good at pressuring on the platforms.
Yeah,
and he's really good at falling through the platforms and continuing combos off the platforms.
Exactly. Okay. Like, when you have Fox that has just so much damage output regardless, and then you're like, you know what? On this stage, I have even more. And you're like, wait, really? What?
Yeah.
Like,
okay, please, you're right. Yeah. You can continue the combos using the platforms. But right now, Imhip already taking off the stock, doing 39%. He's reading Larry really hard right now. But 90%, that's perfect to be able to get neutral aired into up smash. And you see Larry going for two neutral airs already, trying to get that KO.
Man, and Imhip brought it all the way back. But I really want to point out, Kitaro, look at the lineup. We got two
purple.
Yes, we got two purples for Imhip. And right now, the red's slapping away at Larry, but we got the grab. But when you got two purples, it's so strong. Because that side B puts in the tumble, it's going to give Imhip a lot of space. Not enough space for that Nair up smash to connect. You got to be careful. Don't get hit by Nair in this game.
Yeah, do not get hit by Nair in this game. And fantastic stuff by...
You will die.
Yeah, Larry. However, 111%, fifth lightest character in the game. Imhip is already looking to get that up throw with the blue Pikmin. He does have one out. Let's see if he can time it well. He's going to probably throw the purple, throw the yellow, and here comes the blue. Gets that grab. No, too much pressure.
Yep, and here comes the up airs. Waits the whistle out. Almost gets the second hit to connect. But man, Imhip already at 75% from Larry Lurr.
Oh my gosh, and there's an F smash coming out from the yellow. Not too bad from Imhip, 75%. If he can get some Pikmin onto Fox, he'll be okay. However, it's really hard with this infinite pressure being put on him. It's hard to get that space that he's looking for.
And Fox is so good in these tech chase situations. We see Larry just like being able to tech chase Imhip over and over again. And when you have that grounded speed, one of the best dash attacks in the game as well, I mean, you should be, right?
Oh my gosh. Double short hop neutral air on shield to run up smash. Something about Larry just keeps going for that KO option. I don't blame it at this percent though, because you could just go for it and be like, all right, I miss, it's fine. However, I hit it, you're done.
Yep. And very good risk reward. Like you said, coming out from Larry, that up smash out of shield will punish that Pikmin toss coming out from Imhip. And now, I mean, I just feel like even though the matchup's not that great, Imhip is still doing an amazing job with Olimar. He's sticking with his guns. He's sticking with his main character.
Yeah, I agree with this option. I feel like if anything, try to learn what you can do. Try to learn how to do it. And Imhip, he's doing it. And it's going to be Fox vs. Olimar again. Might as well. Right now he's 1-1 against Larry, at least in this set. And I feel like Larry was starting to adapt to the Olimar again. But this time, remember, it's going to be Imhip stage choice. We're going to have Town and City. Let's see if that can make a difference in this set.
So in Smash 4, Town and City had the lowest ceiling out of all the stages, but now one of the higher ceilings in this game. So maybe Imhip just looking for more survivability. He's been dying really early to these up smashes, to these up airs.
Yeah, he wants to take that out of the way. Almost every single stock that was taken by him was these up airs or... Come on, just air dodge. Thank you.
He's going to do it. He'll do it again.
Larry went for 3 up airs. I wonder what he'll go for next. Oh my gosh, another one.
Do Fox players really want to up air me for a fourth time? Yes, they do.
Literally go back 2 games, man. It's the same thing, but 114 right now on Imhip, and this is a scary thing we had last time. He can't get off the ledge.
Yes, the get-up attack will go ahead and depressurize that situation there. The illusion not going to get punished from Imhip to get to that full hop. Yeah, I'm trying to create some space, but Larry finding his way in, falling down on it with that back air.
All right, and Imhip again on the ledge, having trouble getting back up, and this looks like it might be a stock. Yes, it is. I just had a feeling he might not be able to land, and there it goes. 49% only on Fox. Let's see if Imhip can bring it back to that white Pikmin. No, reflected.
Get it off. And man, that was so crazy. Larry just made it look like he wanted to catch the landing, but he just didn't do anything. And then, like, just Imhip whipped the backer right in front of him. He's like, all right, cool, see ya. Like, gives the up smash.
Yep. Every time, okay, here's one thing. This is probably why he's so good against fighting Olimar. Every time white Pikmin is out, he immediately goes for reflector. He'll get hit by the blue. He'll get hit by the red. But when white Pikmin's out, because if you guys don't know, white Pikmin does the most damage by far.
Yes.
So he sees white Pikmin, he always goes reflector. Because not only will reflect it and hit him back to him, does it do more damage? I'm actually wondering that. I don't know if it does. It does.
That in this game, I'm not sure what the properties are, but I definitely know that Boost still kills with that up throw. And that's been a classic going on through all the games Olimar's been in.
Don't worry, guys. Commentators will know everything about Olimar 3 years into the game. This character can be so confusing.
Oh, yeah. And even like just the lineup, it can be very intricate how you play or play against Olimar, because you got to know the lineup. If you know that his blue is coming up next with the purples there, he can also, every time Olimar does a move or a whistle, he rotates the lineup by one. So Olimar's will get tricky. They'll do a short hop up air to rotate one and then come in tomahawk.
Oh, I can see that.
So you got to know the whole lineup, not just the one coming up.
Yeah, exactly. So you have to know like which one's coming up next. Like maybe not just the next one that he's going to throw, but the one after and the one after. Remember, guys, in this game, I believe it's a set pattern. So I remember one of the games, it might have been Brawl, Smash Bros.
Brawl was random.
Brawl was random.
But
there you
go. Pull six.
Wow, I'm old, man. I thought that was the last game. Brawl? The Olimar, the Pikmin thing is random. However, in the last two games, it's good, and that up smash.
It still killed on Town. Like, this character has